I'd like to call a Conway Board of Selectmen meeting to order on Tuesday, September 6th at 7 p.m. First thing on the agenda is to approve the minutes of the August 22nd, 2016 meeting. Make a motion that we approve the minutes.
Second.
Any discussion?
I'd like to.
Good, okay. No discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Minutes approved. Okay, the next thing we have is the warrant articles. The vendor, we have a vendor warrant for $65,014.63. We have a payroll warrant of $87,933.01. And we have a payroll deduction warrant for $23,662.82. Have a motion?
Move that we approve.
Okay, second it. Any discussion?
No, there.
No discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All those minutes are warrants are approved. Minutes attended by the select board members. The next item.
So I wanted to mention a couple meetings.
Sure.
Mostly, you know, just that these are things that people in town do. But so a couple of weeks ago, Michelle Turi had an educational meeting on recognizing Japanese stiltweed. She just puts her heart and soul into trying to recognize stiltweed around the town. And I went to that, and then we spent a couple hours pulling stiltweed. It's important to me because there's a bunch of it in front of my house. So I went to that meeting. And then last week there was a meeting by the DPU. It was a hearing on the Berkshire Gas moratorium.
Mm-hmm.
And Jim Moore came and he gave a good speech. But it was an opportunity for the public to speak to the DPU about why they think the moratorium is unfair, mm-hmm. that they blocked new customers from getting gas. But it was also an opportunity for Stan Rosenberg and Steve Kulik and other reps to put in a plea that they be allowed to be what are called interveners in the process. And a couple days later in the recorder, they announced that they have been made interveners. So I think that'll be good.
Okay. Well, last week, myself and Tom, we went to a planning board meeting. Would you like to talk about that a little bit, Tom?
Yeah, the planning board had its second meeting in a series trying to reconcile various committees and boards and departments' needs for land in town with the land that's available. And the reason they had this last one was there's some land being sold near the center of town, and they wanted to get people's thoughts on that and just let them know that this was something that they'd been paying attention to, Joe Strugowski and you and I, mm-hmm. and Pixie Holbrook for the housing committee went up to meet with the seller, and we wanted to see whether in any preliminary way the land was suitable for any sort of use. And Pixie thought there might be some land there that could be of use for a senior housing project, and gave a very fine, gave some very fine advocacy for that. Nothing's known at this point. It was a good chance for people to get together and regroup and familiarize themselves a little bit more. They've put everything into a nice grid, so all the needs are known and all the requirements of the various groups are known. And I would just like to thank the planning board for taking on that task.
It's difficult, but they're doing a good job of it.
Yeah.
It's good. All right. No other minutes attended by the selectmen. Next item is citizens' concerns. Do we have any citizen concerns? You should know.
None that I know of. No.
He gets select board concerns.
Okay. All right. Next item on the agenda is old business. The first one is the South River floodplain lowering project. And signed a change order to Davenport's about it. Would you like to talk about that, Tom?
You know, we could go into these. These are a little bit involved, and we might want to take Kate as long as she's here.
Okay.
Just to have her be able to
Let's move to new business then, and we'll talk about the New England Wildflower Society request for taking seeds from the town property. And we have Kate McDonough here from the Wildflower Society.
Right, I'm a resident of Conway, North Hill Drive, and I work for the New England Wildflower Society. So yeah, my purpose is just to request permission to collect seed on town-owned properties. I don't know how much you know about the New England Wildflower Society. I can give you a little bit of just the, in a nutshell. Actually, if you look at the back of the cards that I gave you, it's got our mission statement, but it's to preserve, actually I have a copy for you, Tom, as well. Conserving and promoting the region's native plants to ensure healthy, biologically diverse landscape. So we're actually the North America's oldest plant conservation organization. And so we're based in Framingham, but our native plant nursery is in Waitley. And I'm the manager of that nursery. And what we do is we're focused on growing plants from seed collected in the wild whenever possible to propagate and grow. And some of those plants go for restoration projects, some go to our botanical garden in Framingham, some go for sale to the public, some are used by professionals for ecological landscapes. So what we're focused on is collecting seed of common species, not rare species. And actually I have I basically printed out general like permission request letter, and then also we have every year we put together a target species list, which is not necessarily a complete list of everything we're interested in, but it's just some of the higher priority ones, and it's listed by botanical name. But anyway, here's some just that information for your records, if nothing else.
Oh, thank you.
This all came up while I'm always driving around looking at plants and looking for large populations of common species and that I could potentially get seed from. But I generally don't get on land unless I have permission to go on the land, and I don't want to collect seed until I've gotten permission from the landowner. This came up with Conway property because I noticed there's that small island of land right where 116 and Matthews Road come together. There's that little triangle across from the bank of mailboxes, and I happen to be aware of one of the plants that's on this list. It's actually the last one, Zizia aurea, which is, I think the name of the common name is cut off, but it's common golden Alexander. And that was one of the species that I'm interested in collecting seed on. So that's how this came up. But then if I'm going to ask permission, I think it probably makes more sense to just ask for permission for the town properties in general instead of finding a plant and having to keep asking.
So all town properties?
Yeah, I haven't explored all the town properties, so it's not that I have a list of things that I want to collect on every property or specific properties. But I was looking potentially to get permission for this year and next year, or if that seems like too much, just go for 2016 and renew it in the future. Just to get a sense, I've gotten permission from other towns, like the City of Northampton Department of Public Works has given me permission, the South Deerfield Water Department, trustees of reservations, so different private landowners, utility companies like the First Light up that owns Barton's Cove, up that way. So colleges, kind of a variety of organizations, entities.
Now that partial land you talked about in Matthew may not be town property.
Okay.
Only because the old state road used to come in, you know that little small road that goes in on an angle there? It's closest to Route 116. That road was the existing state highway, Mass State Highway.
Oh, okay.
Before they renovated the road and moved the corner out to where it is now. So that's still, I guess, state property right there. So how much of that the town owns, I really can't answer you that.
Lee has a corner of that listed as town property, but the majority of it not, which was confusing to me, but that makes a lot of sense.
That's probably that. She probably got the section that the brook runs through is listed as town property.
Okay.
Where the two roads come together, the four corners right there.
Yeah.
But over further toward 116, where that older oil and stone road is, close to 116, it is old state highway.
Okay.
So, I don't know if they ever, they could have swapped that back to the town when they did the highway.
So did you have a way to talk to the state, or?
That's a whole separate conversation.
just wanted to let you know.
Yeah, no, that's good to know. Because I know when we looked at the GIS map together, and it was like, there was a part of that triangle that was pink, which is, I think, reflective of town land, and so it was just unclear why that was.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think the whole thing is town land.
Okay, well, that's good to know.
Just so you know.
Mm-hmm. Do you provide seeds to people that want to plant things?
The nursery, no. We just collect relatively small amounts to propagate for ourselves. The organization as a whole, we have a conservation department that got grant funding from the federal government to collect seed after Superstorm Sandy to seed bank for big restoration projects. So that, for projects related to that, the organization can. But what I'm talking about is small scale.
Good.
I'm distressed at how little milkweed I see around and wondering, you know.
We do contract growing of plugs, so like that's something we would potentially, if somebody wanted to plant out 50 or 100, they could ask us to grow them out for them.
Do we have any more discussion?
I assume that you know how to gather seeds and for the plants, and I'm not worried about that. So.
Yeah, and if I didn't say this already, we limit our collection to 20% of the available seeds, so we're not just going in and like taking all the seeds.
Taking it out,
Yeah. We want to leave enough for it to just continue.
For next year.
Yeah.
Well, if there's no more discussion, I'll make a motion to recommend we approve her request for taking seeds off the town property.
Yeah.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
No problem. You have something you want us to sign?
Are
you going to send it to us? Or?
I sent you this. Actually, what's the best way to handle that?
Was there something in there?
Nothing.
It's not.
I mean, if you want to, I have another copy of this letter. If you want to just sign it, then that would be.
Oh, that was your request.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be something for us. I think the vote is sufficient.
Okay.
We can send you a copy of the minutes.
Okay.
Perfect. Great.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it, Kate.
Good night.
Thank you very much for coming in.
And so, actually, I guess one question of clarification, is that for 2016 or is that for beyond 2016?
I think we can only do one year at a time, I imagine.
Well, you can do whatever. Well, you can only. Any select board can change what any previous select board did.
But they can't act in the future.
The motion you made was general, it wasn't limited to a particular year.
I would think you probably have to reapply next year due to the fact that maybe some different select board members didn't hear.
Okay.
And they may have different thoughts about it.
All right.
So would you come in the spring? Or summer.
I guess spring
fall
is really busy. That's why.
Yeah.
And most of the seed collection happens a little bit later in the season. But I guess I have to see what plants are out there of interest, because if there's something that I would want in the spring, I need to get here.
Yeah.
For that.
Okay.
Yeah, because we don't change board seats to or possibly a board seat change until May.
Okay.
Elections in May. So. Mm-hmm.
So I should try and get here April, in case.
Well, if you want for the next year,
after May. Yeah.
You're good right now up until July 1st of next year.
Okay.
So.
All right, good.
Yeah.
That's good to know. Great, thanks.
Appreciate it, Kate. Thank you for stopping by.
Yep.
You have a video?
Thanks, Bob.
Thank you.
Good to see you again.
Okay, let's get back to old business here. South River floodplain lowering project, and I guess we have to make some change orders, approvals for Davenport construction.
The original contract required that all the work be done by October 1st. This is because of the turtle habitat, and Davenport requested that they get some extra time to be able to do paperwork and the final cleanup after they were finished with the real field work. And the final cleanup is filling in, ruts and things like that. So it's really improving the land. We all agreed to that, and it was originally going to be a contract change, but the Franklin Regional Council of Governments decided that the original contract was fine. Davenport agreed to that, so all we need is a change order with no change in the dollar amount. It's just in the conditions of the contract. So that's all that's really necessary. That's the first part of it. That's the change order.
Okay.
So might as well discuss that.
You have any other discussions on that?
Huh? We've talked about it a couple of previous meetings too, so, and tabled it.
Okay, if I have no...
Do we have the contract note assigned? Or
yes,
are you
yeah, right here.
So
yes,
we do.
It's,
okay, great.
It's a change order.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
No money change. The money's all the same. Everything's just a change order of the date.
Mm-hmm. Look good, yeah.
So if I have no more discussions, I'll make a motion that we sign the change order.
Second.
For Davenport. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, I'll sign that then.
Good to get that done.
Yes.
We're waiting on that.
It's... they've been very good and, you know, have moved along, you know, in good faith.
Yeah, you can see the project moving along.
One must be for us and one's for them every time. Okay. The next item on all business is the signed the memorandum of agreement with the Franklin County Council of Governments regarding the Davenport payment process.
This just makes it easier and quicker for Davenport to get paid. Normally they would have to invoice the town because we're the owner of the project. We would then send it out to Weston and Sampson, who would approve it and send it back to us. We would then send it to the Franklin Regional Council of Governments for their grant administration purposes. They would send it back to us, and then we would sign it and move it into, move it back to pay Davenport.
All after the work is complete.
What this allows is for Davenport to send the invoice directly to Weston and Sampson, who will send it to the COG, who will send it to us. So we save two steps out of the process. That's all it does, and there's, you know,
so we'll see final copies of that at the end.
God knows how many pieces of paper.
Yeah,
each
I know it's a lot. It's a lot here. So.
Yeah.
But it's the whole contract because they have to include the whole contract in what they're doing. So, and the first part protects the Council of Governments legally, and it's all because there's a substantial sum of money involved. Couple hundred thousand.
Do they
dollars.
Charge extra for that, huh? The council goes?
No.
Okay.
No. Or at least they wouldn't charge us. I don't know. They're dealing with a state grant.
Yeah.
So whatever they do on this project comes out of that grant.
Okay. Well, I make a motion that we approve the contract. You have a second on that?
Second.
Any further discussion? Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, I'll sign this then.
Technically a memorandum of agreement.
I think we've both got to sign this part, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
There's understanding and agreement. Just a plain memo.
So that's, we have a copy of the memorandum of agreement and it sits along with this contract.
Yes. And it says that they can send the invoice to us.
You'll fill out the rest of this up top, probably after?
Yeah.
And stuff like that.
Yeah. That's all.
We hold off on the Energy Committee for a few minutes if they show up.
Yeah.
We can go on to something else in here, I guess.
Should have been here. They're supposed to only go till 7.
Okay. Let's talk about the, under new business, we'll talk about the bi-recycling policy.
We adopted a bi-recycle policy in order to get grants from the state that help us give out, you know, the recycling buckets and such. And the policy has now changed at the state level. They have gotten rid of the requirement that we include the recycling logo on things that we print, which is good. Policy covers all paper office supplies, not just copy paper. So file folders, we're supposed to get recycled too. And we're supposed to get 30% instead of 20% recycled content. Now we get our paper through the solid waste district anyway, so they're looking out for that kind of thing on their end. So those are the major changes in the new policy. And this is in anticipation of the Department of Environmental Protection saying, we need the new policy. We need the signed policy before we can give you your grant money.
And nothing's too onerous.
It's actually better for the town not having to put the recycling logo on, which I, yes, well.
Will they be coming out a bunch more of those containers?
Well, they,
last year they had just a few, and they went like wildfire out there.
We get $500 a year for this.
Oh, okay.
And it's really run by the Board of Health, so, and I don't have the details of that program at my fingertips. But I can tell them that we will take as many as they can get us.
Well, I know that they want us to meet this 30% minimum recycling content. I would think that if there's any means that they could purchase more of them containers for people, it would make it easier for the people to do it. I know the people that got them think they're wonderful, but there was only just a few of them last year.
Well, I'm happy to communicate that to the Board of Health.
I would think that it would be beneficial on their part to get more of them nationwide to people.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I would like to make a motion that we sign the recycled product purchasing policy. Is there a second on that?
Second.
Any future discussion there? Other than...
Sounds easy.
Yeah, okay. No further discussion. All those in favor of signing the policy?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? No, good. Sounds good to me. Okay, we both got to sign this, I guess. Is this the original, or just... This is the only copies we got. There's nothing in here.
There is nothing in there?
I didn't see nothing.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We can sign this.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah,
if there's just the one.
Just one side.
Yeah.
Maybe you got one too? Why don't we sign both of them? The town can keep a copy and they can send one along. Right?
Sure.
Let me sign yours too.
I wrote on mine.
Oh, okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
I can scan it.
Okay.
That'll be fine right there.
Okay, let's see, we sign that, we have an out recognition letter for outstanding community service to Malcolm Course. Tom has put together a very nice letter here to Mr. Course, Malcolm Course, for his work on, he's a member of the 250th committee, and also he was very concerned about the condition of the Veterans Urn over here on the Common across from the Town Hall, and he took it on his own to have it taken apart with the help of some others. Hmm. And he took it down to I don't think it says here, at least Hampton, I think it is, from a plating company, and had it re-powder coated and painted and bought it back, and we helped them put it back up. And the Garden Club, he approached the Garden Club about some of the cost, and the Garden Club appropriated, I think it was $600 toward it.
Mm-hmm.
The Garden Club paid, and I got the talk to Tom about the town picking up the remaining balance, which we did. So the urn sits over there now. It's Helen Baker from Baker Store in Conway donated new flowers for it, and Malcolm has been watering them daily, and the thing looks absolutely beautiful out there.
It does.
So this letter of recognition, just to appreciate what he's done for the town. So I would like to make a motion that we sign a letter to him. You have a second on that?
I'd second it.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Malcolm's support on projects like this is always
huge. Oh, he really got into it big time, yeah.
Yeah.
It's nice we have people like that concerned about the town's
property stuff. Okay.
Well, we don't have Peter, but I'm prepared to give updates.
Oh, do you want to just go right into that then?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
All right. Next item will be under all business will be the Energy Committee update on projects and sign the contract for the construction of the town hall installation.
Starting with the smallest first, the town got a grant, a municipal energy technical assistance grant, to help the town figure out how it could provide solar energy for municipal purposes and possibly to share that with the community. And they engaged the services of a group out of Boston, New Ecology, Inc. They originally had two phases to the project. One was looking at more general questions about what could be done and how it could be formulated. And the second was an actual design of a project. Well, because they don't have a particular place to put it, they put phase two on hold. They just did phase one. And New Ecology did publish a report informing the committee of the parameters of putting up a solar project. And they know a lot more about the content of that report than I do. So I'll stop right there. Also, you probably know we're currently in a sign-up phase for Solarize Conway. This is to try to get as many people together to say that they will install some solar panels so that a large bid can go out. And there's three towns involved in this, Conway, Shelburne, and Coleraine. And all of those towns' requests will be put together and put out to bid, and that should attract some economies of scale for a company that wants to come in and do that. So the deadline for signing up for that is September 30th. So if anyone out there in television land is thinking about doing this, you have until September 30th, but of course it's better if you do it quicker. The last I knew, there were many people in Conway, perhaps over 100, who had expressed interest in it, which is a little different from signing up. But that is the state of that project. The third project is one that's been around for a long time, which is the major project that we had in mind when we got the Green Communities grant, which was insulating the town hall. After several redesigns of the project, when the bids came in much higher than we thought they were going to, we finally put together a design and specifications where we were able to get a bid, which was within our budget. And this is a company, Goss Construction. They're actually out of Hartford. But they are anxious to work with the town of Conway. And the guy sounds great, writes good emails. We're going to have a pre-construction meeting sometime soon. And the Energy Committee accepted the bid. And this is the contract there that was set up by our engineer. This is her standard contract. She's done a lot of these kinds of projects, and it does have everything it needs in it. It may look a little bit different than the standard town contract, but that is what I am requesting that you sign tonight, is the contract with the winning bidder on the town hall insulation project. It would take them about 30 days to do the exterior work and another 2 weeks inside, and he wants to get it done before it gets too cold out.
Yeah.
So that is what they're supposed to be reporting to you is. One more detail on that. They had a main phase of the project and an ad alternate in case the bid came in and we had enough money to do it, and his bid was substantially lower than someone else's who, I guess the engineer was more familiar with the other company, but they came in several thousand dollars higher. So it is the recommendation of the Energy Committee, which it's too bad Peter isn't here to deliver in person, as I understand it, to go with the winning bidder, which they're pretty much required to, unless they want to rebid it again, and I'm sure they don't want to.
And so this money is paid from a grant.
Yes, this is the Green Communities grant, which is already paid for redoing all of the lighting in all of the town buildings. And the next major project was the town hall insulation, and it's taken us until now to have a successful bid.
We, in previous meetings with the Energy Committee, they had samples of what
I saw some samples, yeah.
And they showed us buildings that have been done in the area, and I went out and looked at one of them. They looked very, very nice.
Yeah.
Good, good. Yeah, the one up in Sheldon?
Right.
Yeah.
Being on the outside, you know, you'd worry about that.
It looks quite nice.
Great.
All right, if we have no more discussion, I would like to make a motion that we sign the contract for Goss Construction. I hear a second on that?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye? Okay. I will sign the contract. Should I sign this, or do you want me just to put John to sign it, the chairman? It does say chairman on it, so.
Oh, well.
Chair, we can Board of Selectmen, yeah.
It's chairman, Board of Selectmen.
You can just cross it out.
Cross out, okay.
There you go.
You are the chair pro tem.
Yeah.
Okay, you have to get somebody to test this.
Yes.
Ah, Becky.
Yes.
Test of my wonderful signature.
There was one detail I forgot about this particular contract. It's designed to be notarized.
I will have everything with me tomorrow, but I...
You see that I witnessed
this
signing
for
you,
okay?
Okay, let's see. I guess that completes the old business for today. And we go on now to items not anticipated 48 hours in advance of a meeting.
You have nothing.
Okay. Town administrator update. Do you have anything for us?
I do. Oh, I think there's an extra one. Actually, I'll give that to you. Well, this just reiterates what I said about the Energy Committee for both the Meta grant and the Green Community grant. Beyond that, for committees, I am working with the Personnel Committee on a policy for reimbursing the town for training expenses if employees leave prior to 1 year of service. This is a common clause in a lot of town personnel policies that if you come into a town and you get a lot of training or you have some expenses that are paid for you, that you reimburse them if you leave before a year is up.
Do you have a way to collect that?
Well, there are things that are allowed and things that aren't allowed, and the Personnel Committee has been very helpful in sorting those out.
Great.
Yeah, because sometimes some of those concerns are actual license issues, so, which would benefit them in the future somewhere else. So.
Yep. For departmental news, Michelle Duguay, whom you met, started as highway clerk today, though she will usually be working Fridays. We have received some initially disappointing news from FEMA. Our application for a hazard mitigation grant for Delabar Avenue work has been turned down. According to our engineer, MEMA was surprised it was not accepted and is inquiring as to the reason. Since I wrote that, I did get a two-page report from FEMA outlining why they didn't think the application was good enough. Both the person who put together and I think that they were not reading it correctly, and that we actually have a much better chance if we apply. I say here there's a very slight chance we might be able to successfully appeal the decision. So we are going to try that. I have a conference call. Well, there's a email out requesting a conference call with our MEMA contact to see how we can strengthen the application. It would mean $270,000 for us in funding.
Yeah.
Now, that said, we might also try again next year because we didn't make the first cut this year. So it doesn't mean it's that the proposal is dead, and we will have for the money that we are spending on this that we took from the highway winter roads at town meeting, we will have a design. We will have a complete bid-ready design for the project. But we won't be able to fund it with FEMA money until, well, they have a very little bit left that they didn't spend.
FEMA?
Yes.
Yeah.
So a whole lot of people are going to be going after a very small amount of money.
Right.
But we figure it's worth trying anyway. So I'm going to be on this call, and we'll have them, you know, clarify the points that need to be clarified and resubmit.
I think if after your call, if the project is still dead to us in the water here, after your call, Tom, you're sure that it's not going to proceed, we probably should get the highway superintendent to come in and sit down and have a meeting as to what our next move here should be. Because I know it's a very large concern of the citizens up there, mm-hmm. of the riverbank conditions and the road starting to cave in.
Yep.
And I think that something that we probably better get going as fast as we possibly can.
Well, that's why it's important that we will have bid-ready documents. We will have a complete design as to what should be done. Mm-hmm. And I know that the highway supervisor is interested in that because he would like to get a jump on some of that work and have the highway department do it itself, mm-hmm. At least the basic drainage work from the road. That's one thing that we could do that would help to stabilize the situation.
Well, if you could get him to come in, because I'm sure we're going to, if it fails, totally outright fails, we're going to have to discuss, you know, financial aspects of it, where money would come from, and how much it would take to get to where we got to go for this year at least.
Yeah, and I still think we'll be able to submit again for next mm-hmm. year, but there certainly should be some interim
yeah.
steps taken, and right. he certainly is aware of that and is planning to take steps, so I'm sure he'd be happy to communicate them to the board.
Yeah, if you could come in, we could have some general discussion on it, if that takes place.
For other projects, the South River project had a bump at the beginning with some invasive plants cut earlier than intended for the schedule, but we hope to take care of any problems during next spring's follow-up. Aside from that one misunderstanding, everything seems to be going as planned. I had a good meeting with Joe Markarian in preparation for the long-term financial plan meeting later this week. That's tomorrow night. I look forward to getting together with the treasurer and assessor and members of the Finance and Capital Improvement Planning Committee to start working on long-term financial planning, including creating and perhaps even agreeing to a number of helpful policies over these meetings. But we'll be working on those policies probably for the next year or two anyway. But the more we can get done during our meetings with Joe Markarian, the better. The information technology security plan is moving forward as well. had a conference call with the principals, and we've agreed to an outline of the content of the major deliverable document. This is something that will become our computer policy, computer security policy. Tweaking it for Conway is also on the agenda. That's they're creating a template, and then they're going to tweak it specifically for Conway.
So this is like a FERCOG? They're doing it for all of us?
Well, we are the test case. It's a community compact project that is being run through the FERCOG and into Conway. I had started discussions with them probably a year ago on this, and they're actually both of these, the financial planning and the cybersecurity, they're working on behalf of all of the Franklin County towns.
Great.
In order to help move anybody who is using this community compact forward. So those are my items.
Just before we leave these items, getting back to the South River project.
Yeah.
We still moving forward on schedule with being able to get something done this fall as far as securing the agricultural status of that piece of property. And we talked about, they said that you had to get some fall plantings in.
Yes.
Rye. Have we done any more on that?
There's been lots and lots of information shared. Have we actually moved forward on it? No. Yeah. But we're closer. There seems to be some timelines that are under question, and the Conservation Commission is going to take this up a week from tonight as a conversation item, a discussion item, and I hope to have some more clarity after that as to...
Were you going to go to that meeting?
What the status is. Yeah, I'm certainly hoping to go to it. So.
Great.
Yeah, because that seemed very vague at one of the previous meetings.
Well,
it's kind of like, well, we think, but we're not sure. And
There are different agencies involved, and different agencies have different timelines and different definitions and that sort of thing. So that we're dealing with a difference between the Massachusetts Department of Environmental Protection and the United States Department of Agriculture. As I can see it now, that seems to be what's the difference here. Mm-hmm. So we need to find out what the Conservation Commission's thoughts are on on that, and before we go forward, if the Conservation Commission is satisfied with using the USDA criteria, we do have someone lined up to do some planting, and we should be full steam ahead. So that's the only hang up right now.
Okay. Good. I just wanted to mention.
Yeah. Well, it's. Treading water.
Treading water. Okay.
No, not standing very firmly on anything right now.
Okay, the next item is concerns of the selectmen. Do we have any?
No.
Hey! Mr. Peter, how are you?
We moved along very quickly, and I gave a preliminary update along with my understanding that the Energy Committee wanted the select board to approve the contract.
We did, and we did vote to accept the bid, GAS.
Which is good, because they went ahead and signed it.
Oh, good. Okay, so you don't need me. It went much longer than I had anticipated over there. Anything else you need from me?
Well, do you know what the numbers are for the Solarize project?
I don't. Bryce has those.
Okay, that's what I wondered.
He's got a better handle on that.
Isn't that like 120 people interested?
We got a good response for the people that came in. And he said there really was only 10 to 20 people who were inquired who didn't have sites at work. And that's across the group. So good response.
It seems like there's a lot of people that haven't signed up yet, though.
People expressed interest in trying to do the closing. It's like anything,
right.
You know, everybody,
right.
You know, real.
Well, after they hear the, I'm one of them, like after we heard the complete package, I decided I wasn't going to do it.
Uh-huh.
Because the only place I had that I could do it on my property, it couldn't give me my whole 100% advantage that I wanted.
Yeah. Well, that's it, if you're gonna do it. I mean, I managed to catch a window that's gonna work, but I'm gonna have to put a tracker in, so it's... But...
So what I have works great.
I figure, hey, retirement's gonna buy me no electric bills. Let them raise their rates, I don't care. Well, thanks for signing, guys.
No problem.
We're moving ahead.
Thank you, Peter.
Have a good night.
Yep.
Thanks, Tom.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, the next item, if we have no concerns, the select board is mail. We have a couple items here from the mail. Mass DOT sent a letter to us advising us that the Mass DOT all-electronic tolling fare structure public hearing is going to be Wednesday, September 14th at the Springfield City Hall, 36 Court Square in Springfield, Mass.
That's for the Mass Pike, they're putting up things that'll take a picture of your car. If you don't have an Easy Pass responder, if you want one, you can call them. It's proving
them.
Actually somewhat.
They have those over the pike now. You know, they're already.
They're in the place
and
working.
Yeah,
they are.
Be interesting to see how it turns out. And the other letter we have.
A lot of concerns people have about privacy.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. The next thing, letter we have is a letter from Comcast advising us that the Massachusetts Broadband Institute has, I guess, would you like to talk about that? You probably know more about this than I do.
Comcast and the MBI have finalized their agreement, signed all the agreements. We should see trucks around Conway, you know, right now.
Great.
They've started on the project. Yeah.
And do you know roughly what part of Conway they're going to be starting working?
They'll be working all over town.
All over town.
Yeah, and it should be done within 2 years.
Now, they're only going to get up, they reach somewhere at 96% coverage?
The commitment in the contract says that they needed to reach 96% coverage. They gave us a preliminary set of maps that were much closer to 98% coverage. We have no guarantee those are going to, you know, they were preliminary. So I am anxiously awaiting, and it will be a few months until they have another set of maps.
Most of our citizens' concerns are from the Williamsburg polling district, I guess, right?
Yes.
And out towards Scripture and Shelburne area.
All of the homes down in Southern Conway are being wired on the original maps that we got.
Wow.
All of the homes on the Asheville border are being wired. Wow. All of the homes out Whately Road, South Part Road, Roaring Brook Road are being wired.
Nice. And how about the Shelburne end? Is that?
That's all wired.
That's totally wired.
Well, except for the wires like the Topman House, you know, and down to the bridge, and that's all wired. So they were all wired on the original maps that we got.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
I don't know whether people sign up or not, that's their prerogative.
That's up to them, I know, yeah.
We should stare for the
option. And the wire will go by their house.
Nice.
It'll go by Mike Kirkalonis' driveway. As of now, they haven't committed to go for them to pay to go down his driveway to his factory. But they consider, you know, that Comcast has a set driveway policy that if you're more than 200 feet down the driveway, then they will negotiate with you over what it will cost you for them to run the additional length to your house.
Okay.
And what I can say is that in the North Conway project 3 years ago, they were very generous.
Did they give any estimate of completion?
2 years.
2 years. That was complete. Good.
And they say across all of our towns, not any particular town, again, we're going to get schedules, in 18 months, we will have 50% of the project finished and turned on and working. So half of the houses, hopefully in Conway, will be working in 18 months, and the other half of the houses will be finished 6 months later.
Great.
But I don't know which ones.
Well, I'm sure you don't.
And it'll probably take them 6 months to start hooking people up. They're doing poll surveys and a lot of preliminary work.
Well, there's a lot of stuff
that's necessary.
Yeah. And like with our town, they ended up being about a month late finishing the project, and they blamed it on Verizon.
Yeah.
they could do that again.
Good, good. Well, if I hear no more business from the Board of Selectmen, our next meeting will be held on Monday, September 19th, 7 p.m. in the town office right here, in the town office.
So how about one announcement?
Okay, sure.
So I mean, I don't know whether this is really an announcement, but you know, I mentioned the invasive plant work that Michelle Turi did a couple weeks ago. So Lori Sanders is going to be in, I'm pretty sure it's this coming Sunday. I wrote the date down just so I would know it. Not where did I put it, but... So it's this coming Sunday anyway, at 4 to 5:30, it's going to be at the Rose Field, and it's going to be to look at other invasive species, like Japanese knotweed, and how to recognize them and what to do about it.
I'm sure she will be shocked when she shows up to see how much work's been done.
That's okay.
Because they're really going to town on it.
She's mainly interested in down along the river. All of the knotweed is down there along the river. You know, all of the things she's worried about are still there.
Great.
So, and she's tremendous. If this is more for the television audience, but if you haven't been to one of her talks, she's really great.
Yeah, it was great the day we were there.
Yeah.
Very informative.
She is, yeah.
Great. Okay, if I hear nothing other than mentioned from the Board of Selectmen here, I'd like to make a motion that we end the meeting.
We adjourn?
Adjourn.
So move. Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.